Well, hello there. I'm Michael, and I play the fabulous Rufa, and this is what you missed in episode 26. Itchy and Morel enter the king's cave to discover hundreds of goblins running around with large boxes. Itchy stops one of the goblins to ask them what's going on, but they profess they cannot talk because
Baron Boger is always watching.
Itchy and Morel then look around some more to discover the captives locked in a large cell, and upon seeing this, they decide they need some more assistance to find the key and head on back out to inform the other adventurers. When Itchy and Morel explain to the rest of the group what they found, they also profess that the goblins are too busy to care, much less notice some trespassers, which seems like a signal that something important is happening soon. The party then promptly enters the cave, and immediately Alona examines the crates the goblins are toting. Inside are hundreds of goblin-made explosives and shackles. Alona pockets one of the bombs and urges the rest of the party to find the key. Rufa discovers a large ornate door with a magical lock, and Itchy overhears some hobgoblins ordering underlings to get the subjects ready for the boat. Desperate to find the key, the adventurers disarm a trap and enter the room, which they soon discover is the King Big Boss's office. On the desk, they discover a shipping manifest and an inventory list, but the most important discovery of all was a self-portrait of the King Big Boss. Just kidding. But he does have 13 abs though. And they also discover a letter from the evil genius Mango Maw, confirming that the captives would be used in his monstrosities and that he is creating an even bigger new unit that puts Leontari and Lova to shame. Additionally, there is a letter stating that the orcs are close to creating a treaty with the Blue Rock Tribe and may close on it soon, filling the adventurers with a more overwhelming sense of urgency. Also in the room is a chest, which Alona quickly realizes is covered with the symbol of Ravan, Devil God of Chains. In it are three keys. One is a key to release the prisoner. Two is an ornate key with the symbols on it to open a magical door. And one key is the key to a temple of Ravan. The adventurers take the keys and head on out of the office. The adventurers head right over to the cell and unlock the door. And among the imprisoned, they discover the mayor of Malimos and Awan, the Chainbreaker, champion of Agarunrun. Awan confesses he was planning on blowing up the cave before he learned there were other captives inside. But the adventurers presented him with the perfect opportunity to set the prisoners free and burn it to the ground. Alona instructs the stolen people to take as many boxes of explosives as they can carry to their cart outside of the cave, and Morel and Aaron lead the charge. With everyone safely out of the cave, the adventurers take the magic key and open the magical locked door. Inside, they discover a massive King Kong-like bugbear with a small, irate goblin on his back. They refer to themselves as Baron Boger and Great King Big Boss, and true to their name, a boss fight ensues. The bugbear then takes Alona and punches her squarely in the face, which enrages Itchy, who one-shots him without even officially having rage. Rufa, Chonibus, and Itchy all take shots at the Great King Big Boss, but his blood is cursed, and they all get persistent damage from hurting him. Then, Rufa takes him down with a pebble to the back of the throat with a cruel retort about his artistry skills. With the boss defeated, the party hears a ringing of a bell, seemingly to signal a ship docking under the cave. And that is where we end episode 26 of Edge of Legend. Make sure to tune in at 8 p.m. Pacific Standard Time to the Nat20 Productions official on Twitch to catch the newest episodes of Edge of Legend as they happen. We look forward to seeing you in chat as you become legends right alongside us. Thank you for watching.
Thank you.